take it. The price is too high. Feelings are gone. It seems the river's run dry. You never imagined it could turn out so rough. You're giving, giving, giving. Still, it's never enough.
Good morning, everyone, from us, Dave and Sue, on this Monday. The first day of sharing about multifaceted love. We want to say thank you for the feedback we received about the last sharing that we did. It all started when we were at Angie and Ty's blessing ceremony. Samuel used the term multifaceted love.
You may have recognised the song that introduced this reflection this morning, but if you didn't, it's a song by Don Fransisco called Love Is Not a Feeling, It's an Act of Your Will.
Well, we agree with that up to a point. Love is certainly something you give and do. Acts of. But when you receive love, it gives you a feeling.
There have been many videos shown since the Queen's passing. One that stands out for me is her visit to Ireland 10 years ago when she shook hands with Martin McGuinness. Many deaths of innocent people on both sides of the political argument had hardened people's hearts. But that picture speaks to me of forgiveness and reconciliation. It gives me a warm feeling inside. I love to think of the healing that was happening. Martin and Ian Paisley, bitterest enemies, had become known as the Chuckle Brothers because of the times they spent together laughing.
In 2001, we were sent reeling when Sue was diagnosed with lymphoma. Life became different. We had new priorities and we had to learn to deal with things differently.
I found that I couldn't read fiction. It held no interest for me at all. Searching the bookshelves, I found this book, The Love Life of Every Married Couple. And don't worry, we're not starting a counselling service here. This book ties up with Samuel's phrase, multifaceted love, because it tells how the Greeks have five different words for love, not just one.
The first two we won't concern ourselves with, as they are only concerned with marriage. But the other three give us insight as to how love and the lack of it shapes our lives. The first of the three is storge, S-T-O-R-G-E. I quote from the book, this could be described as a comfortable old shoe relationship comprised of natural affection and a sense of belonging.
This love, referred to several times in the New Testament, is the kind of love shared by families, friends, a fellowship, a community, a tribe, a country, could be even all humankind.
When the world shows itself as a cold, hard place, storge offers emotional refuge. Without this love, we are in a house that has no roof as the rain can pour in.
The next is filio, again often appearing in the New Testament. Filio cherishes and expects a response. It is a love of relationship, comradeship, sharing, communication, friendship. A place where you can share thoughts, feelings, attitudes, plans, and dreams.
Yeah. The last is probably well known to you, agape, A-G-A-P-E. The totally unselfish love that is unconditional. The love the Father shows us and asks us to show others.
C.S. Lewis showed the difference between agape love and the natural loves by using the picture of a garden. He described the natural loves as a garden that would soon run to weeds if left alone. This is inevitable because of self-centeredness, willfulness, etc.
Agape love acts as a rakes, hose, shears, plant food and weed killer, employed by a skilled gardener to keep the garden thriving, orderly and beautiful.
Tomorrow we shall go a little off-piste, as skiers say, when they're going to leave the known track over the white snow slopes and maybe find things underneath that they weren't prepared for.
We finish by reading part of Paul's letter to the Corinthians.
Dave and I read this at Zoe and Pete's wedding. We mentioned multifaceted love then. And when they were on honeymoon in Greece, they made an unscheduled stop in Corinth. Much to Pete's surprise, he found an obelisk with 1 Corinthians chapter 13 on it.
He said to Zoe, "Your mum and dad read that at the wedding."
So we will read 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 8. Love is patient.
Love is kind.
It does not envy.
It does not boast.
It is not proud.
It does not dishonour others.
It is not self-seeking.
It's not easily angered.
It keeps no record of wrongs.
Wow. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth.
It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
Love, it never fails.
Now a blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Amen.
Join us tomorrow when we see love in God's creation.
So you say you can't take it, the price is too high. Feelings are gone, it seems the river's run dry. You never imagined it could turn out so rough. You're giving, 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 still it's never enough. Your emotions have vanished, once held a thrill. You wonder if love could be alive in you still. You'll never forget the words you promised that day. Jesus didn't die for you because it was fun. He hung there for love because it had to be done. And in spite of the anguish, his word was fulfilled. His love is not a feeling, it's an act of your will. Love is not a feeling, it's an act of your will.